So I'm not one to say I am a subject matter expert on any vehicle I play in the game, but honestly, out of all the times I've spent with this vehicle, I think I know it pretty darn well. So welcome back to the channel, everybody. I'm your host, Nathan, and today we're going to talk about a vehicle that's really, really slow, but really, really powerful as well. And honestly, I think it's one of the best vehicles in the game. So without further ado, here is the Azov 64131. Hope you guys really enjoy this video. If you like the channel and its content, please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting, and please share the video as well. So let's get into this. Roll the tape. The company Kamaz has a reputation of building large, heavy, powerful vehicles. The Kamaz 65228 is no exception. The vehicle in the game of SnowRunner is the Azov 64131. A brother to the 73210 and the 5319, the Azov holds true to what these vehicles do best, grinding through terrain. Recently, the Azov was voted number one on Focus Home's most popular truck contest. While this vehicle is not the fastest, most powerful, or the most exciting, it does the job with consistency, giving drivers confidence with its dependable nature. The 64131 has a ton of upsides for players who like the slow and steady pace, and a lot of downsides for those who like driving the fast trailblazers. So, before we jump into the pros and cons, let's take a look at the base stats. The Azov 64131 is classified as an off-road truck. It weighs 17.8 tons. In its stock configuration, it has a power to weight of A-, a durability of A, fuel consumption B+, fuel capacity is 93 gallons, it has a stock suspension, its tires also come stock with a 47-inch all-terrain tire, its all-wheel drive is always on, and its diff lock is always on as well. Alright, let's dive into the pros and cons of the Azov 64131. So, like usual, with the bad news first, coming in at the number one downside, it's slow. SnowRunner is a pretty slow-paced game, but it can be sped up to rabid speed with trailblazers like the Azov 5319. The 64131, however, has one pace, turtle speed. I haven't done a whole lot of speed tests, but I can confidently say that this is probably one of the slower vehicles in the game. For the players who like to speed run or fast track progress, this is probably going to be your biggest downside or issue with the Azov. I talk a lot about upgrades being side grades due to trade-offs, and I believe this is the case for the 64131. The lack of top-end speed could be a counter to its strengths, and we will discuss those later, but I need to mention that it doesn't go fast enough to really damage itself all that much. Downside number 2, small tires and limited variety. Upon inspection of tire options, drivers find out that there's no potential size increase and no other tire variants. The 64131 has the smallest tires in the Azov fleet at 47 inches. Not being able to choose different tire loadouts or even have the option to increase tire size kinda makes the Azov boring in this department. Although it's common knowledge that the Azov brothers don't have much when it comes to tire options, I felt this was a downside. I would have loved to see this get a 3-inch upgrade to 50 inches like the rest of the truck line, but I feel this would make the vehicle somewhat overpowered. That 3-inch upgrade would make such a difference though. Downside number 3, ground clearance and no raised upgrade. So far we see it's slow, it has small tires like the American trucks, and now we come to realize that its ground clearance isn't that great at all, nor can it acquire a raised upgrade. I really never noticed the lack of ground clearance until phase 1 when I was trying to crawl through rocks. I later confirmed this in phase 2, 3, and 4 when I felt more influenced to use lower gears quite a bit more. On the OG maps like Michigan, Alaska, and Tamir, I could trust automatic and it usually stayed in 5th gear most of the time. However, in recent phases, I've noticed I got stuck more by sinking down to the truck's frame. With no active suspension upgrade like the 73210 or larger tires, this vehicle accumulates so much more ground resistance in those new super heavy areas. With more content releasing, the troubles caused by our number 3 downside continue to occur. Downside number 4, front overhang. One good thing about the 64131 is that its front overhang is less pronounced than its two brothers. I do have to admit that it's still a damage magnet due to our number 2 downside and our number 3 downside. With fast changing terrain, the engine is going to take hits. While I don't think this is a deal breaker, just know that you're gonna get your nose stuck sometimes. However, you usually can push out and the vehicle is pretty durable and able to take a beating. Downside number 5, turning circle. To be blunt, the Azov has a pretty large turning circle. This will cause issues with winding trails and turning the vehicle around, especially with a trailer attached. Due to the slow nature of the 64131, it does give you time to start your turns early, so I don't think this is a big deal either. Just be aware that it's not the most agile truck. Downside number 6, somewhat limited add-ons. A little later we'll talk about the great utility of the 64131, but on our number 6 downside, I feel I need to mention the limitations and add-ons. Being that the vehicle has a very short frame, it's still gifted with using most add-ons in the game. However, when attaching a small crane with either a high or low saddle, you cannot attach a fuel carrier semi-trailer or the heavy fuel tanker semi-trailer. Its short frame also prohibits use of the short logging add-on as well. To be honest, for such a short vehicle, it has so many attachments. Truly though, the SnowRunner developers could have stripped all those away, only giving it a high and low saddles, like some vehicles with longer frames. I must say this is a downside, but I'm thankful that it can attach almost everything. And finally, coming in at the number 7 downside, terrain limitations. As mentioned on our number 3 downside, the Azov has trouble with rocks and deep bogs of mud. In these new phases, rocky areas and super deep pits of mud seem to be a regular thing. Even with a short wheelbase, the 64131 still runs the risk of being high centered on rocks. Trouble with boulders and super deep mud are attributed to our number 2 and 3 downsides once again. I believe this downside could be mitigated with an active suspension upgrade and larger tires like the rest of the Azov line. Most of the time though, you can still claw your way through those deep pits, but I'm finding I use my winch a little bit more these days. To mitigate this downside, try avoiding large boulders and be aware of winch points in super muddy areas where you feel like you're just in some quicksand. Looking back on those downsides, to think about it seemed pretty harsh, but the upsides are worth it, I promise. Here are the pros for the Azov 64131. Coming in at the number 1 upside, power, all-wheel drive, and diff lock. The vehicles in the Azov truck line seem to have similar downsides, but they also have similar upsides as well. The 64131 shares its top engine with its brother, the Azov 5319, the TUZ Warthog, and the Voron Grad. As I've stated before, this is one of the stronger engines in the game powering this lumbering Tortoise. That power, coupled with the always-on all-wheel drive and diff lock, create what I say often about vehicles like this, a plug-and-play easy-mode Russian truck. I think about 30% of my mission completions in my first playthrough was with the Azov, and I never had an issue pulling anything. All that great power to 8 wheels, all diff locked, is part of the reason this vehicle is popular amongst the SnowRunner community. Upside number 2, heavyweight. There's some speculation that this vehicle should be put into a different category due to its heavy weight. It's the heaviest off-road class vehicle at 17.8 tons, weighing more than heavy trucks like the Dan 96320. In all my truck reviews, I either praise or scrutinize weight, and I do this because it either aids or hinders a truck's grip. Because of this advantage, I feel it has the best grip in its class while still boasting a good power to weight. As we continue this list, it will start to make sense why those downsides had to be so bad just to balance the Azov for the game. Upside number 3, stability, balance, and short wheelbase. Stability and balance are things that I look into heavily when choosing a vehicle I wish to deploy. In flat areas it's not so important, but with the new maps, I feel there are a lot of gotcha points causing trucks to get thrown off balance. The Azov has a tall silhouette and one would infer that it would be prone to tipping, but it's actually quite stable. Most of its weight is evenly balanced longitudinally, and the vertical center of gravity is low, keeping it well planted on the driving surface. I believe our number one downside could aid in this because it gives the vehicle time to respond to changing terrain. The suspension travel is good, yet the frame is rather rigid, which I believe helps this as well. And lastly, the vehicle's short wheelbase helps with keeping more wheels on the driving surface and somewhat mitigates getting high-centered. Upside number 4, fuel economy and range. It's common to find trucks that are powerful, have large tires, and are super fast, but it's rare to see a vehicle have great range and fuel economy. This upside actually is and has been my favorite since I first drove this vehicle in its stock configuration at driver level 2. To put this in perspective, some vehicles burn more gas at idle than the Azov when at max speed going down a paved road. Recently, I've had speculation and belief that its fuel economy was nerfed, but even still with upgrades, the fuel burn is still efficient. The 64131 has a large 350 liter fuel tank to add to its great economy, which makes it a vehicle that can stay out longer on the job than most. I've actually debated using this vehicle in its stock configuration to reminisce of the old days seeing those insane fuel numbers. It might not get the job done as fast as others, but it will work longer, giving drivers room for error along the way. I believe the only vehicle that has a greater range is the Zix 605R with its easy terrain navigation, fuel tank, and roof rack supplies. I'm very critical on this category, but I have to say that this is my favorite upside of the 64131. Upside number 5, utility. Despite not being able to use those things listed in downside number 6, the Azov can use most add-ons and trailer options. I briefly mentioned before that realistically, due to its short frame, it should be a high or low saddle only, but I'm so thankful that I can fully utilize this turtle with all the attachments. I also need to mention that the 64131 has a rooftop snorkel and a spare tire location that keeps it away from the driving surface as well. Upside number 6, consistent and dependable. Our previous upsides listed built a strong case for the 64131's credibility of being a consistent and dependable vehicle. To truly understand this upside, you just have to play it, but let me elaborate a little bit. The Azov goes one speed most of the time, it can travel great distances, and drivers have minimal chances of having to be rescued. I used to call this vehicle confidence, because when deploying it, I knew it was going to get the job done. Its performance is consistent, and you can count on its strengths, making it a great vehicle to put heavy workloads on. Upside number 7, it's one of the best stock vehicles. I briefly mentioned this vehicle's stock configuration and how it was still a capable vehicle, and trust me when I say this, it's not an exaggeration. Another great stock truck to use is the International Paystar 5070 because of its ability without upgrades. I believe you could use the Azov without upgrades and still go through the whole game. If it truly wasn't the best stock vehicle in game, drivers like myself wouldn't be scrambling to sell every truck, trailer, and add-on to purchase the 64131 at driver level 2. And finally, coming in at the number 8 upside, it slows the game down. I know some might disagree in slowing down an already slow-paced game, but for me, I enjoy that type of gameplay. In my first ever truck review on the International Fleet Star, I said that I don't necessarily want to speedrun the game, but I do like making up time where I can. From using this vehicle so much in my early days, it helped me understand game mechanics, memorize terrain, and just enjoy it while learning as well. I feel as though slowing down the game, you can help avoid a lot of error by giving yourself more time to think ahead and then act appropriately. For guys like me, you must walk before you run, so that's why I felt this was an upside. Alright, so moving on to my personal ratings for this truck. For power, I gave it a 4 because it shares one of the most powerful engines in the game currently. For terrain navigation, I felt a 4 was fair. It would have been a 5 if it could take boulders better, had higher ground clearance, and larger tires. Due to the power, always on, all-wheel drive and diff lock, and everything mentioned in the number 7 upside, it's one of the easiest vehicles to use. An easy 5 here. For aesthetics, when I first started playing the game, I didn't think it looked very good, but I think time has changed my mind. I think a 4 is good. Stability is good despite a tall silhouette. All those things mentioned in the number 3 upside show it's a really stable vehicle. A definite rating of 4 here. Due to its low fuel burn and large fuel tank, this vehicle sets itself apart from others here. The rating of a 5 is a no-brainer. Despite having a short frame and all those limitations from our number 6 downside, I felt a 5 was fair due to being able to use most things. Heavy weight, 8 wheels always diff locked, and great power carry this vehicle to a rating of 5. So in conclusion, the Azov 64131 is a capable Tortoise, and I must say that I probably could have made this video quite extensive. I'm surprised it was voted most popular, but that's not why it's my favorite. I tend to gravitate toward vehicles that can do everything good. The Azov doesn't have crazy gimmicks like some trucks. It's just a slow, steady, capable, fuel-efficient, hard-working truck, and that's what I admire about it. Its downsides have become more pronounced with newer phases of the game, but it's still lumbering on. I believe if those downsides were remedied, it would create an overpowered vehicle. Those downsides to me feel like the developer's balancing factors, so I don't think they'll ever be fixed. Some people like to get things done at a fast pace, and I can respect that, but we all know the story of the tortoise and the hare. I hope this review gave you a fresh new perspective of the Azov 64131. Please smash the like button. Definitely share this video with someone who is struggling with the game, and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you don't miss any future content. Hope y'all have a wonderful day, God bless, and stay upright.